Was a nice needle. Look at this. Was a nice trip. And it was an insane needle. What a needle. What's up, guys? Here's Inspector. So many will come create a great video. And also another Clash Royale video. We are here to play the Clash Royale. And also with the Golem Palms that I made a poll in my community, and all of my subscriber, about 80% of my subscriber, vote for playing Golem Palms or Golem Dark Prince Lumberjack in the mid ladders, because you know that I'm now concentrate on the mid ladder. Before to introduce a bit about this day, if you're watching my channel for the first time, please like the video, comment your opinion, and also make sure to subscribe to the channel. We have any video from the mid ladder, top ladder, or any level for a Golem player, from beginner to the top player. So I was concentrating on the mid ladders, because I'm going to make a more video for mid ladders. Some of my subscribers have still problem in the mid ladders, and also if you're a top player, the mid ladder will be so important in your any level of your skill, because mid ladder makes you more power and makes your tower trade technique stronger. So please keep going to the on to this video. And also, some of our subscribers say that the Dark Prince should be removed from this, and the E-barbs should be changed, but both of them are known deck and both of them are great deck, but I think in some cases the Dark Prince is better than the E-barbs, and also in some cases the E-barbs is really better than the Dark Prince. But I'm going to play the Dark Prince because it's a Golem Pox and also a beat down and control decks. Let's go ahead to our battle. I'm going to speak about in the oldie battles. If you would like to learn the Golem, please subscribe to the channel. So the best card, the Galaxy Collector in this deck, is here. So I'm going to cycle my cheap card, because the Bomber is two Electro. I'm going to play the Dark Prince here. Looks like a graveyard RG Electro Giant in any deck. It's going to be a graveyard. So I think Dark Prince is better than... was a nice NATO. Look at this. Was a nice traffic NATO by the Spectre. I surprised and inspired. So our opponents is inspired and surprised too. And was it great? So I'm going to using so many elixir. I'm going to play my Phoenix here to defend this push. So I'm going to play another Bomber and cycle my second Lexi Collector. So the arrow was so bad. He sends well played. I think it's going to be GG, because when the Golem control has the two palms and has the Lexi management, the surely within this match. One of the important and one of the most important things in this deck is keep your palms alive and manage your elixir and justice. I'm going to play my Dark Prince here. Another great reading the God Barrels. The right Dark Prince shouldn't be ignored, because if our opponent ignore it, it will be massive damage. He plays his Valkyrie. Best time for the tornado. I'm going to ignore the Valkyrie and push control and support my Golem on justice. This deck is so great for any Golem player that wanna learn from this stretch, and it's so funny and strong. This, I think, it's the best and strongest deck in the 2023 in the Golem meta. So it's going to be GG. I think our opponents give up, and we're going to play another push. Justice. The first and the most tips in this deck is make your collector alive. If you have your collector in the map, surely you will win the dark. You will win the, I don't know, Lexi Golem even, or even graveyard, or even any decks that ignores and annoy you in any battles. So let's have a good luck and GG. We're going to the next match. The best cycle and the best star for the Golem Palms is that seeing your electric collector to your next card, because you know that the electric collector isn't in the start of the game. So concentrate on the match. I'm going to wait. I'm going to wait and send the good luck. Bomber. Wow, if it's be a, I don't know, cycle or lightweight, it will be so hard for me because we haven't any lightning or zap, and the electro dragon is not able to reset the inferno so rarely. So I'm going to play my lumberjack to have a big push and see my opponent's card and also cycle my Lexi Collector, Lexi Golem. Lexi Golem is so dangerous. But the Dark Prince control is going to be so dangerous for us. I need one Elixir. Nado, please come! But Nado comes so late. But another Dark Prince here to cycle. Another pumps. If you cycle your pumps, any dex is easy for you. As you see, I'm going to defend and cycle and play another Elixir Collector. But it's better to make and select Elixir Golem here. The Elixir Collector here, because maybe he has a, I don't know, fireball or rocket, so I think we're going to lose that Electric Collector, but I don't wanna. Wow, it was a great arrow. Great arrow. But still, we are ahead in the Electric count. We have to play a Lumberjack here. It was not a good defense, but I didn't think so that he's going to play his E-Barbs. I'm going to play my Dark Prince to cycle another Electric Collector. Cycle your palms and Electric Collector and win the match. If my Dark Prince is be in my hand, I will defend the, our opponent's E-Barbs. Dark Prince is the most sure card to defend it. So don't be hurry here. Don't be hurry. We're going to play our Golem here. If we lose our tower, no matter, because a so massive push will come. We're going to have a massive comeback. He's going to yes, it was a nice Nado again. The Nado is key in the attacking, and look at his, look at the Dark Prince, Electro Giant, the Electro Dragon, and all support card are in our enemy's cover, and it's going to be GG. So insane deck. I really love this deck. If I wanna change my Golem first play deck, I will choose this deck because this deck is so lovely and so strong. As I told you, as you see the banner up and the thumbnail of the video, this deck is the best and the most usage and the strongest deck in the 2023. We're going to the next match. I hope it be a hard counter deck because we're going to watch some different decks. It's going to be Lava Hound, I think. The guards identify your enemy's deck. No. The God King and the Death. It's going to be lightweight. It's a spell based card, but it's so hard counter against for us. I'm going to wait and now play my Tornado, but it's going to play this card. Look at our E-Dragon. Our E-Dragon is stuns. The guards, the God King, and the minions. I mean, the minion horde. If we will be a Golem first play, was so great. As you see, the archers is here. We play our arrow to his old card. I'm going to wait. Play my bumper here. Surely he has, I don't know, skeleton. Skeleton barrel or god barrel, I think. Or even miner. Dark Prince is here. Lumberjack is here. We are not in the good position. But we are, I think now, from now on, our Elixir and our gameplay will be shown to our opponent. I'm going to play my Golem from right side because my right side tower, the mage, and I'm going to defend my right tower at first and then have a big push. So he's going to play the minions. So I'm going to keep my E-Dragon and Nado. 8 Elixir I need for this action. E-Dragon is here. Dark Prince is here. I'm going to play the in the distance because ignore his any spell, then it's going to be GG. He knows that he's going to lose if before double elixir he couldn't take my tower, and then it surely we will lose. It was a easy match, I think, for us. He controlled the match, as I told in the first video. This is Golem control. You have to control your opponent, you have to control the match, you have to control the any tension and any situation in the map and in the games. The next match, so we have Bomber and Lumber. Wow, it's going to be a Golem. It's going to be a mirror deck. I love the mirror matchups. I'm going to play my Lumber deck here. If he plays this Golem, I'm going to play my E-Dragon. Wow, was a risky action. I play my E-Dragon here, but it's no matter. It was no matter. E-Dragon is here. I'm going to play my Lexi Collector. His plays is Musketeer for nothing, I think. Dark Prince is here. The Dark Prince is not able. Look at our Nader. The mini pickup was insane. Mini pickup was great action. Just a well played to our opponent. I'm going to play my Golem push. We can also cycle our Elixir Collector if our opponent... No, I'm going to play my Golem here. He's playing his Rocket. The Rocket is so dangerous for us, but he cannot use his Rocket to defend our push because he's played his Rocket now. What should we do here? Play Lumberjack or E-Dragon? I will learn you how to control this match. Lumberjack from behind. E-Dragon is here. I think he hasn't much elixir to defend. He plays Nightwish, Skeleton King, and also his ability. Nice tornado. Was so nice to me, I think. To get the tower with this tornado, yes, it was great action by the Spectre. We bait his rocket and we get our goal. E-Dragon, please back. Thanks, E-Dragon. The E-Dragon heard our sound. Another rocket here. It's a great action because we are getting one elixir more from our opponents with this rocket. He plays a rocket to elixir collector. It's true that both of them are 6 elixir, but we will get one elixir when our elixir collector depleted. Another E-Dragon. Count your opponent's card. He plays 3 cards. Maybe he plays his rocket. So I'm going to play my cards in the high defense. A great action to ignore the any rocket player. The Nado is here. Wow, we missed the Musketeer, but no matter, we get these matchups. And it's a so insane deck. I love this deck. The next match against Chino. And the first tip that I told in my any kind of video, identify your enemy's deck even with any decks, no matter if you are Golem deck or your Cycle deck, identify your enemy deck. I'm going to concentrate, so it's going to play this Princess. Looks like a Light Bait deck, looks like a Cycle deck. The Bandit, I think it's a Dark Bait. Great action by the Then if he's going to place Barrel, I'm going to activate some I'm Smart with the Tornado. As I told you, it's a Dark Pit card. Dark Pit is so dangerous for us because he has a Rocket and he can't push our Golem so easy as ABC. Wow, what a great Tornado. Look at this. What a great Tornado, and it's a insane Bomber to get the damage, but look at the E-Dragon. Our E-Dragon compensated a bit damage, but I'm going to still play my Lumberjack here to add first. Kill the Bandit and then going to Princess, but our opponent going to play his Dark Prince. The Phoenix is here. I'm going to play my Dark Elixir Collector here, but I need 10 Elixir for this action. Dark Prince is here. It's going to be double Elixir, and so for the end, I think the most hard battle in this video is that another insane tornado. I can't play that Dark Collector. Now I think it's the best situation. He's going to play his rocket, I think. No. You wanna keep his rocket? The dragon is here. If he plays the rocket, it would be great. No. I need 4 elixir for defend the darkness if he plays his barrel. But no. Dark Prince is here. Nice. The Dark Prince is insane. I love Dark Prince. Fantastic E-Brops in this deck. Great NATO is here. Wow, what a NATO by the Spectre. Wait, he's going to play his rocket. Wait. No, he hasn't any much electric to defend it. And look at this. It was a hard counter, but look at our push. It was magnificent push by this Spectre. It's going to be GG. So, so lovely matchups. Was so lovely matchups for the Golem and our opponent say, what should I do here? And let's have a GG for him. Let's claim our rewards. Rising the meat ladders. If you like, please tell me on the comments. Would you like to upload this deck in the top ladder event? Or the Golem first play in the top ladder? So, the last match in this video, I hope that you would love this match. It's going to be Mother Witch. I think it's RG, Royal Giant. But the event Royal Secrets, probably Royal Secrets Bumper, going to be an Electro Giant. Electro Giant, I'm going to cycle my card. Look at my Electric Collector. I played 3 cards, but my Electric Collector isn't here. If he plays E-Giant here, I'm going to play my Dark Prince here. I'm going to play my Dark Prince here. Yes, his plays is 4 Elixir and Gob Cage. E-Dragon. He's going to play Lightning, I think. Yes, he's going to play Lightning here. What should we do here for our opponent? Play Lightning, because Lightning is so hard counter for this deck. Play your Bomber. Accept this damage, is no matter. And play your Elixir Collector. When your opponent play Rocket or, I don't know, heavy spell, punish him with a Elixir Collector. I'm going to ignore the Mega Minion, so 3 Elixir will be in my pocket. Play Golem from opposite line. The Electro Giant loves to play directly with him, but I will ignore this action. If he has 7 Elixir, surely he'll play the Giant, but I'm going to play my Phoenix here, and I'm going to ignore the Electro Giant. He has as much Elixir to play his Lightning, because he's played the God Cage. Play the Lumberjack here. Still, we are ignoring the Giant. Dark Prince is here. Bomber is here, the Phoenix, please survive, but no, it's going to be so, so dangerous matchup. The Collector here, but I still want to wait to defend the East E-Giant. The Dragon is here, his place is Electro Dragon. We lose out. Electro Dragon so cheaply. I'm going to use the Lightning card. Our tower is not in a good action. We have to defend it. We have to play defensive capability. Bomber is here. Phoenix is here. E-Giant is here. E-Dragon is here. And it was an insane NATO. What a NATO. I'm going to play NATO so dramatically and so fabulously in these matchups, and it's going to be GG. We win this hard counter match. The Electro Giant with the Lightning card and the Bowler. If we do the Golem first play, surely we'll lose these matchups. And we'll win these matchups. Thanks for watching until this end of the video. This deck surely is the strongest meta in the Golem. Surely is the best Golem deck and the newest Golem deck. Use it and make your skill increase your skill with this deck. And just farewell until another great video.